Hello, my name is Christophe from Almax easyLab. Our company is specialized in high-pressure diamond anvil cells, related instruments and accessories for the high-pressure research community. We also offer a very extensive range of diamond anvils, diamond windows for your specialized applications. In this short video, I would like to present you our Optiprexx PLS, which is part of our Ruby line product family. You can also find more technical information on our website or by contacting us via email. Using a diamond anvil cell to generate high pressure is not sufficient, as one also needs to think how we're going to measure the pressure inside the device. Traditionally, it is achieved by tracking the fluorescence of a small piece of ruby as a pressure marker inside the diamond anvil cell. The Optiprexx PLS, or photoluminescence system, enables you to carry out this measurement in an all-contained solution in the comfort of your laboratory. The model presented today is the Optiprexx PLS green laser version, equipped with its optional interlock cover for laser safety. The Optiprexx PLS comes into two main variants: the option fitted with a green laser at 532 nanometer, and the option fitted with a blue laser at 450 nanometer. The difference is mainly about the pressure range you want to measure. For pressures up to 50 GPa, you would select the green option, whereas a blue laser option would be more adapted for pressure above 50 GPa. Both versions deliver output power of 50 milliwatts. In front of the PLS, one can find two buttons easily identified by their color. A green or blue one to start the excitation laser, depending if it's a green or blue laser, and a white one to switch on the LED inside the Optiprexx PLS, which is going to illuminate the front of your diamond anvil cell. On the top of the PLS is mounted an observing microscope, which can be used either with an eyepiece or a CCD camera to observe your sample and the ruby pressure marker. The PLS has a big advantage to be a completely enclosed system with all its optical components, spectrometer, power supply, and all the optics inside its protective casing. There are only two connections to the outside world: the main leads at the back to power the device, and the USB cable to connect the PLS to a PC, enabling the user to run our proprietary software HPM, High Pressure Manager, but I will come on to this point later in the video. On the breadboard of the PLS is a manual XYZ stage, which can be fitted with the universal V mount, where we can fit the diamond anvil cell. For this video, I have kept the calibration plate supplied with the system. In the case of the interlocked PLS, we need to close the cover mounted on two sliding rails. On the top of the interlock is a small window offering the possibility to look safely at your diamond anvil cell whilst the laser is on. The ruby fluorescence spectrum can be observed by using our HPM software, which comes as standard supplied with a PLS or RubyLux. HPM is presented in more detail in another video available on our YouTube channel. But basically, it offers three main panels, which will be enabled or disabled depending on which USB devices are recognized by the PC and the software. It's done automatically for you. In this case, we only have the PLS connected, which is activating the Ruby spectrum panel, and the CCD camera here on the third panel and the IGM are deactivated because these devices are not connected. Finally, it is important to note that all this data can be saved in files and correlate measured spectrum, calculated pressure, and all the different information about your experiment. If you want more information, be it technical or commercial, regarding this Optiprexx PLS, its option, and very importantly, the suitability of this device for your experiments, do not hesitate to contact us via email, and our technical team will be more than happy to try to help you and guide you. Thank you for watching this video.